Hello ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Anmol Astrology channel. Now today's video is about the important time periods for relationships. So this is actually a sort of snapshot technique. All you need to know is that what your ascendant is and where your Venus is placed, both in D1 and D9 chart. So what this technique tells you is that particular period is going to be a significant period in terms of your relationship. And I'm not talking about this thing that you can predict when your marriage is going to happen through this technique. It's just about to know which time periods are going to be significant, like there are going to be challenges, major challenges related to relationships or even marriage in your life. Okay, so now what you need to do is that take your D1 chart and take your D9 chart as well. Whenever Rahu and Ketu are transiting the first 7th axis of your D1 or D9 chart, or Rahu Ketu are transiting over your Venus of your D1 and D9 chart, these are going to be the major periods of your life regarding relationships. And one more thing, if we talk about dashas, then Venus Rahu, Rahu Venus, Venus Ketu, Ketu Venus, and then even Rahu Saturn or Saturn Rahu, these periods are very prominent, with which comes with challenges in regards of relationships. Okay, we'll talk about what sort of results we are going to get through this in the further video. Right now you need to know this thing, that whenever Rahu and Ketu transit from the first house of your D1 or D9 chart, they actually bring in a major transformation in you as a person. So suppose if you are in your early 20s and you have never had Rahu or Ketu transiting over your ascendant, that means till now you are not transformed. You're not aware of what you are. Because what happens whenever Rahu is in the first house, and suppose we have Venus in the first house and Rahu is transiting over it, and Ketu is in the seventh house, what happens is that Rahu is going to amplify your personality. You are going to see those parts of your personality which you might not have seen earlier in your life. It's like that there is some, you are given a sort of dose because of which you are intoxicated, and now you are just doing all the things without any control. You're just presenting yourself as you are internally. There's nothing which you can hide. And same happens when Rahu is transiting over Venus. You present yourself like internally as you are in relationships. And the major part is that Rahu is a bit selfish energy. So what it does is it always thinks about himself, that I want this, I am going to achieve this. Then what happens is each and every person is actually internally self-centered. So in relationships, or during this time, whenever Rahu is transiting over Venus, or Rahu is transiting in the first house of D9 or D1, what happens is that you become quite open with what you are, and you become quite selfish in some terms, because Ketu is in the seventh house. So Ketu is detaching you from partnerships. Ketu is detaching you to understand that you have to love yourself first. And it brings out parts of you which you have never seen. So that's why Rahu brings major transformation whenever it transits over Venus or in the first house. And most probably whenever these time periods come in, there happens to be a breakup, or at least if you are married, so at least you'll have a separation. By separation, I don't mean divorce, because honestly, I've always seen breakup with the such time periods, but I'm regardless of which Mahadasha you are going through, because we give importance to initiate an event to the Mahadashas, right? Mahadashas, Antar and Pratyantar Dashas. But these transits actually work regardless of whichever Dasha you are going on. So most probably there is a breakup associated or a heartbreak associate. But if you are into a marriage, then it can simply cause physical separation for some time. Okay. Now the other thing is, whenever Ketu is transiting your first house, or it is transiting over your Venus, then what happens is that you are into that healing process. This is the time when you are into healing and self-realization process. You tend to remember things from the past. All the realizations hit you that where you were wrong in terms of relationships or where you were wrong generally in your life. So it becomes a path of self-realizations. But Rahu is in the seventh house and Rahu is the Bhoga Karaka. So Rahu is going to give you relationship during that time, but that is going to be challenging enough. And if you pass that test of Rahu, if you go through the complications of Rahu, then things can be settled. And during this time, you can follow one remedy, which is quite simple, that whenever you wake up in the morning for that 1.5 years, because Rahu and Ketu transit for 1.5 years, even if it is in your first seventh axis or even if it is over your Venus. So what happens is that what you need to do is you need to have a long mirror, a full size mirror in your room, and whenever you wake up, just do first thing in the morning that watch yourself in that mirror fully. Because what happens is in the mirror you see Rahu and Ketu together, your face, your head and your body together. So that helps Rahu and Ketu to come together and take a proper decision and do not get confused in the process of transformation. But on a whole, the purpose of this video was that these are the time periods where you are going to have major transformation in how you express when it is over Venus, then how you express when you are in love, what is the meaning of love for you, and when it is transiting through first and seventh house, it brings in transformation in your own personality and you get to know what you actually want and what you really are on the inside. So if we people understand this fact, then of course things can prosper and relationships can be saved, because I would again mention there's not necessary that there is going to be a major breakup which is not going to settle anytime. But separation does happen. It can be for some time or it can be for long enough. Because when Rahu is in the seventh house, you most probably get into relationships with people who are manipulative and who can come there with some motives as well. So these are the time periods which are important in terms of relationship. I hope I have made them clear. If you guys are new to my channel, don't forget to subscribe, like, comment and share. And you can even press the bell icon so that you get posted whenever my video is uploaded. Okay. And if you guys would like to have your personal readings from me, you can check out the link below, www.anmolastrology.com. And under the consultation section, you can book a personal reading for yourself. Okay. Bye-bye. Take care.